Catan, a multiplayer board game designed by Klaus Treiber, first published in 1995. Catan is an award-winning strategy game, where players collect resources and use them to build roads, settlements, and cities on their way to victory. The max amount of players in Catan is 3 to 4, while the actual play time is 1 to 2 hours. Catan, to say the least, takes lots of brain power to win. You must be 2 or 3 steps ahead of all your competitors to win. So today, I sat down with the 4 greatest Catan players of all time to see if this was just some fun family board game or a ruthless art in which you must be the best. Welcome to the Catan documentary. Before just jumping into any game, I first had to meet the 4 horsemen of Catan. Let's start with Quinn.
Yeah, just sit there.
I'm supposed to face this way towards the camera.
Just face towards me. So, Quinn, how are you?
Dandy, how are you?
Doing swell. Would you like to tell me about your Catan history and a little bit about yourself?
I'm 17, play golf, but I'm dropping all other things and becoming a Catan expert.
Oh, sure.
My Catan history, I won 3 of the first 4 games, went on a dry spell, but we put in the new expansion yesterday, and I was able to get my 4th dub and join the club of 4s of me and my fellow competitors, Ryan and Peter.
That's amazing. So 4 wins in total.
4 total.
Truly, truly amazing.
Yes.
Now, who's your main target in Catan tonight?
Generally, I go in with no really real enemies, but I'm going to have to settle with Ryan today. He's been chirping me quite a bit, and I'm just going to have to settle with him.
Is there anything you'd like to tell the viewers?
Just love that we're doing this. You know, it sucks that we're all in quarantine. It's nice that we get to give the viewers a kind of inside peek on what our lives are like in the Catan circuit.
Truly. Good luck tonight, sir.
Yeah. Prayers for everyone. God bless all.
In conclusion, I learned that Quinn's a good man and truly has a deep passion for Catan. Next, I decided to learn a little bit about Peter.
Hi. Welcome.
Thank you for having me.
Yeah, of course.
The first thing I noticed about Peter was he was really tall.
Peter?
Yep.
Was it? Yeah, that's awesome. So would you like to tell me a little bit about yourself and your Catan game?
Well, I'm a 4-time Catan winner.
Wow.
Yeah, I would consider myself pretty lucky. I'm not the brightest up here, but, you know, I'm pretty lucky with the rolling the dice part.
That's amazing. Would you like to tell us anything else about yourself?
Just that I'm coming for Ryan, bro. That's it.
Oh, ruthless. Thank you.
Thank you for having me, sir.
Yeah, of course.
It'll be a fun day.
See you tonight.
What I learned about Peter was that he truly was a nice guy, but I'm not sure he has the brains to win a game like Catan. Next, I headed for the man, the myth, the legend, the Boomer.
I heard you're referred to as the Boomer. So would you like to tell us a little bit about yourself and your Catan game?
Sure. Like I said, I'm affectionately known as the Boomer. That's because I'm a little advanced age. So my memory's a little worse. My reactions are a little slower. My analysis a bit jumbled up. So I'm not the strongest Catan player.
Mm. Okay, Boomer.
But I feel like I can hold my own. I'm out of 13 or 14 contests. I've won 1 time. So I'm a pretty poor player, but I feel like I'm getting better every day.
That's awesome. Would you like to tell us who your main target is for tonight's game?
Well, it's just not tonight's game. Every game that I play, I target the one known as Ryan Shanley. mostly because he likes to get in our face when he makes a good move, and also when we don't make the move we're supposed to. So I'm looking forward to targeting Ryan tonight and in every other game that I play at Catan.
Wow. Would you like to say anything to the viewers?
You know, I would just say, you know, tune in. I think you're going to get a great match. I think you're going to get a lot of suck words. And I think you're going to see Boomer come on top, I would say once over the next 30 to 45 days.
That's amazing.
You don't want to miss that.
Yeah.
Thank you. Nice meeting you.
It was finally dawning on me. The one that they have all been speaking about. The one single target.
For Ryan. We're with Ryan today.
Ryan Shanley.
Which brings us to our final interview with Ryan Shanley, the supposed most hated Catan player in all of the land, being the final fourth horseman and the final member of the Four Win Club. Take a seat right there. How are you?
Good.
That's great. So would you like to tell us a little bit about yourself and your Catan history?
I'm Ryan Shanley. My Catan history, I had a rough start to the game, but pulled off an unheard of 3 victories in a row, much to the disdain of other Catan players, and that's kind of made me a target, especially to Dad. Other than that, I've had one win other than that, gave me 4 wins, tied with Peter in first place, and Quinn as well, I think.
Yeah, I heard you are part of the 4 Wins Club?
Yep, that would be me, hoping to make it 5.
Wow. Yeah, truly. Anything you'd like to say to the viewers?
Enjoy watching me win another game.
Wow, ruthless. Thank you. I'm really not sure what all the hate was towards Ryan. He seemed like a pretty nice guy, and just definitely seemed strategic and smart enough to win a game like Catan. But the stakes are high for tonight's game. Will the Boomer win, thus destroying the competition between the Four Wins Club? Or will it be a brutal battle between Ryan, Peter, and Quinn to be exited out of the Four Wins Club and into the 5 Wins Club? I then decided to go on a ride with Peter, who wanted to talk to me about something before the game starts.
I saw something you can't put on the documentary. Just cut the cameras for a little bit.
Okay.
There used to be a guy named the Shepherd. And he was one of the best. And then one day, supposedly, when Ryan came in, he just disappeared. So.
Disappeared where?
We don't know. We think his soul went to the hole, but been gone ever since. So that's why I'm playing this game, so I can get the Shepherd back one day.
Do you have any videos, footage, anything of the Shepherd?
We have one film of him. Daddy was a spirit, wasn't he?
That's truly beautiful. So, how did the Shepherd impact the game of Catan?
Well, he used a strategy called the Only Sheep Strategy.
Could you tell me a little bit about the Only Sheep Strategy?
It was a unique strategy employed by one of the prominent players of Catan, known as the Shepherd.
Dad, where do I start?
You collect as many sheep as possible with really no use of sheep, like, in your mind. But
basically, 100% of his focus would be on gathering as many sheep as possible to ward off the other players. He would then turn those sheep into additional resources. And he was just a really good shepherd who protected his flock. And I wouldn't say it was always successful, but it certainly was a creative strategy. And probably will go down as one of the most unique and brilliant strategies in the Catan history.
Thank you. We'll be right back.
After setting up Catan, I decided to call all four of the horsemen for a pre-Catan lunch discussion. Here is how it went.
Good afternoon, fellas. I gathered you all here today for a pre-game discussion before the big Catan game. Quinn, you currently have 4 wins, along with Ryan, Peter, and the Boomer, you have 1 win. So any thoughts, ideas, anything you'd like to say before we get started?
Just looking forward to it.
We had a nice discussion until things got a bit more serious.
I just can't wait to see Peter freak out when he loses this. Should be excited.
Yeah, and I just want to say I will be gunning for Ryan this whole night.
Gunning for Ryan.
I will say with the
flinch. Get that on camera.
Ready?
Flinch.
I will say, I think.
Whatever you say, okay.
It's funny because he's bad.
All right, thank you for your talk, and I'll see you guys in a few minutes.
It was finally time for the opening dice roll, in which it would decide the order for the Catan players.
Peter, your dice roll.
Hang on. Start. Let's go!
Next was placing your opening settlements and roads. This can make or break your entire game. Now that everyone's settlements and roads are placed, let the games begin. It started as all Catan games do, slow. Besides establishing trade partners and gaining resources, the Boomer did get a lot of wood. But besides that, it was just the beginning of a great adventure.
Ryan, I'm a steelhead.
I hate you.
Whoa. This is unreal.
The first to do that.
Goodbye.
It was all fun and games. Till the fight.
I'll tell you sheep, Ryan. Do some?
Sure. My trade route is close to you.
For what? You want sheep right for hay?
Really?
I'll trade you two snow for sheep.
No.
Two snow. I got you three stones.
Don't give any hay. You have no access to hay.
And after losing the boomer, Peter proceeded to lose all respect in Catan.
Yeah, don't you want to buy the Bellman card?
So Peter,
I literally asked you.
Peter, one thing.
One, you said no, I'll go
to
two.
Peter, one thing you gotta understand when you're doing a 3-1 instead of a 4-1 is now Dad has 3 stone. Do you know how difficult it is to get 3 stone?
You know how difficult it is to get hay for me?
It's easier than trading in 4-for-1.
It's literally impossible for me to get hay.
You're just a on 4-for-1. Now Dad has 3 hay for no reason, for having 1 resource. You're just dumb moves to the stone. So you have another stone, so it was literally pointless now. It was literally pointless to get that 3 stone for no reason. Why?
He gets a 7.
Fuck me. Period, genius. Okay. Adios to half your cards.
Okay, I don't need these cards. That's what you get.
Karma.
What do you got?
I didn't need these cards. I don't need all these cards.
Karma for not trading, being a terrible human being.
You literally didn't talk to me, and you're having a conversation.
Because you told me you wouldn't go 3-for-1, so why would I do...
That's the face. The face of a man who just lost everything to Catan. Ugh. Midway through the game, after 2 giant fights, I thought now would be the perfect time to talk to our players.
So halfway through the game, I'm feeling pretty good. My biggest spot is I have 5. I have a city and a settlement on 5, and I also have a 2-1 bricks there, so that's my biggest spot now. I'm kind of mad at Peter, as you see, because he made a horrible move of doing a 3-1 trade for 1 hay, where he could have done a 4-1 to the bank for no reason, which gave Dad 3 stone to build a city, which pretty much put us back a little bit. But I like where I'm at right now. Not too concerned about Dad. He doesn't have the best land. The one thing I'm really lacking right now is stone, but anytime a 3 or 5 shows up, I get it. So, feeling good where I'm at right now. Most scared of Dad, but he usually falls apart late game because he doesn't think that far ahead. So,
I have like 3 points, and only because of a victory point. And I would be in good shape, but Peter kind of screwed me over on the last turn, as he didn't trade 3-for-1 with me, and instead I'm with Dad after first declining me. But I'm working hard out there, sweating obviously, been hydrating a lot, you know, just staying focused, staying ready. I'm excited to see how this game turns out. Ryan seems like he's pretty strong right now. Wouldn't be shocked if he came out on top, for he is probably the best guitar player of us all. But I'm just enjoying being around just some great human beings and just enjoying this game on Easter Sunday, and I hope you all are the best.
Good game so far, pretty tight. Some early good moves made by Ryan and Quinn. I like where I'm at right now. I do have lots of access to hay. I'm trying to build something around stone, which I need to secure, but I got 2-for-1 log, and I got 2 settlements on a log. So if I can start building some cities, I think I get a good shot at this. Right now, I like where I'm at. Feeling good, got good momentum. Thanks.
Yeah, well, you know, just numbers gotta start hitting. The numbers just gotta keep on hitting. You know, get some development cards and, you know, just get after it. So, let's get after it, boys.
and change had much to say. But man, I still think them cats are crazy. They were asking if you were around, how you was, where you could be found. I told them you were living downtown, driving all the old men crazy.
So after a brief intermission, the boys were back playing Catan.
I'm doing that trade.
Documentary, this is what's known as a boomer turn, where the boomer takes all of our time wasting a turn.
You're supposed to think ahead.
Finally, the inevitable happened, and another argument sprung up.
I have no hate spots, and I just got two hate. How is that bad?
Still has no spot.
Do you get that I have no hate spots?
He doesn't.
And I just got two for, and he got one.
What can you possibly need hate for right now?
Save it.
What are we going to order?
Spot so no one can try and steal my head.
This is the face of a man who has just lost an argument in Catan. But here's where everything of this game changed. Here's where something so truly unique that we caught on camera, live, that will change the history of Catan forever.
He's alive!
Shepard, how have you been?
That's right. The Shepherd, the legendary Catan player, was here, right in front of my eyes. Only rumors from that video. It was beautiful. Left as quickly as he came, but he was beautiful. You saw the Shepherd?
He came downstairs, and I've never felt so much joy and relief in my entire life. All the weight of stress in my life was just immediately relieved.
It was amazing.
This next argument is completely stupid, so I gave them higher voices. Enjoy.
You said you got rid of 4A, and now you're saying you got rid of 3A.
Yeah, because I was given 4A, right?
So did you discard 3 or 4A?
I was given 4 and I discarded 3. Because I discarded 4.
What? You said 4 before, so.
Yeah, and I discarded 3 hay, 2 lars, and a sheep.
Honestly, I don't.
This next part is referred to as the Boomer versus Ryan.
Bad for you.
Hello? Hello? 3? Hello? 3?
Hey, same exact name, but more likely.
Anytime you use up, you get 1 vein resource. Redbrick is so useless right now. The only reason Redbrick is good is because I have this. Just like the only reason you wouldn't be good is because I have this.
You get 2 for 1. You have 2 for 1. Not on that.
Yes on that.
Yeah, okay. What's hit more, the 5 or the 8s?
8 is objectively more likely.
Okay, but you have 3, I have 2. Do you understand? 1, 2, 3?
Yeah, but this way screws both of us.
I'm just tired of them listening to you. Stop listening to Ryan and play our own game.
It screws me over too. I couldn't.
Saying to stop listening and play your own game.
He has a reason why he's saying
when he did listen to me, you got a city for free on one of the best spots of the 2-1 board.
Okay, but you're pissed because I'm trying to beat you.
Yes.
Great.
Correct.
But I don't tell him where to put it.
You did the same exact thing with Peter to me. And you won it.
God, stop. You're making me feel stupid.
You're just treating me like I'm a little kid. He doesn't know how to talk. Don't trick him, guy. He doesn't know how to play.
I'm trying to help you out. You're an idiot.
That's what it sounds like. You don't know how to play, Peter. We're just going to move on.
Dude, all I need is a 4, 5, or an 11.
I'm on 5.
Let's go.
There you go.
3.
So many developers.
One sheep.
By the way,
I didn't talk about the first set. And then 4 to 1.
I personally like to call this next segment Bitch Back.
Stop doing this back and forth, bro. Just do what's good. Do what's beneficial to you. It's more annoying to hear you bitch back.
Fine.
It's way worse when you bitch back. I'm saying when you say yes and then no, the deal's already been made.
No, we
have. Okay. I'm just telling you, don't do that.
One thing they've actually exchanged.
Fine, I will trade. Holy moly.
I forgot to mention the number one rule of Catan. Don't bitch back.
I don't understand how mad at me for that. I didn't. I deal with it all the time.
Can I have a sheet, please?
Yeah, I'll give you a sheet.
And so it began, the final homestretch of Catan. 2 more points and you could be a winner. This could be performed by gaining a city or 2 settlements. They fought hard, backstabbing, trading, and yelling, while eating their food, inching closer and closer to victory. After all the arguments, wars, and laughs, the score finally came down to... It would be a final brawl between the Boomer and Ryan.
Well, you know, we're nearing the end of the game, and chances of me winning are not looking too slim, so I think at this point, I'm just going to try and stop Dad or Ryan or anyone from winning, you know? Just try and delay the inevitable, but... You know, this is a fun game, hard fought match, but get them next time. Thank you.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Plain and simple, I'm not gonna win this game. I'm not good right now. But I'm excited to see how it turns out. It seems like the Boomer and Ryan are in a tight battle, and it's fun to watch. Both great.
As I predicted, I thought Ryan did very well. Kept his momentum going, good strategy, made it all the way across the Catan land. It's getting to the bitter end. He's probably in the best position right now if he can secure one more settlement. I'm trying to win with hay. I've got a lot of settlements and cities on hay. Now have access to stone, was a big move. Cut Peter off from any hay. And then Quinn's kind of the outsider. So I think Ryan's probably going to win. But I'd like my shot if the dice go my way, and that's what needs to happen in Catan. So look forward to seeing who the winner is.
Feeling pretty good right now. Need some more fives to show up, and then I'll pretty much have it done. If I can get the 2-1 settlement on the hay, it'll pretty much be game over. Anytime a 6 is rolled or 4 is rolled, it's pretty much game over if a 3 or 5 is rolled. So or an 8. So if any of those numbers show up, it's pretty much game for me. So I'm feeling pretty good. Thing is, with Catan, you can get pretty unlucky. Someone could pull ahead with just a few good dice rolls, like Dead. If he rolls a certain amount of 9s or 8s in a roll, it's pretty much game for us there. So, gotta dodge 7s and gotta hit the numbers I want, and I'll get it. But, yeah, I feel like Peter and Quinn haven't been doing much this game. Dad's really the only one putting on a much fight, but Peter's been known
to sneak some victories in. If he gets a bunch of fives, he could pretty much be game over because he's got that 2-1. But I'm feeling good.
Oh,
guys, that is 8 points too.
Yeah, but
you're about to get nine.
They don't have to worry about Boomer.
Where is he gonna move?
Boomer's got nowhere to go.
We can avoid it. Like you two are gonna win. We're just trying to avoid it, right?
Oh, see ya.
Hey, when you've absolutely screwed this game, going through sheep.
How many of
these guys?
7.
Yeah,
oh, God.
That didn't last long.
Wow.
Peter, sheep for hay? We need.
He's got hay, dude.
We need hay. We need all three of those. Take from him.
We need the hay, baby Icky, right?
Or the red brick.
Right, then I'm gonna use.
That's such a scumbag.
I'm gonna use my knight and steal your hay.
Wow, you guys are actually about to do this right now?
What?
Oh my god.
That's another 7.
That was a 2.
It was a 2.
Oh,
it
was 2.
I have no resources.
What were you going to do? Tell me where you were going to do.
Fine. Jeez.
I just said do it.
What?
You alone are screwed up.
They have done no.
I could have gave you my stuff.
The game's intensity grows as Ryan and the Boomer fight. Peter and Quinn just doing everything and anything in their power to stop the inevitable.
You have to have to survive one more turn and then we can take it away from him.
Peter has 9 points too.
I'm just giving him a law. I'm not giving him anything.
Alright.
He doesn't have 2-for-1 law.
This is...
And now he's going to build a law and spot, two
dude. You probably just got him the win. He's 2-to-1 sheep.
I didn't give him a sheep.
Yeah,
he needs...
I can't build a settlement somewhere.
We can build a road.
You can build 2 roads. Which means if 5 pops up, you win.
So do you.
Nice.
It's your turn.
Very epic.
But if a 7 pops up, then I don't win. He has a good chance to win.
Yeah, I only have 7 cards.
Let's go.
See?
Right,
that was my gamble. Like,
build a road.
I've done my sentence. But committed no crime.
Well, clean up.
And bad mistakes.
Let's go.
I've made a few.
Everybody's gotta live. Everybody's gotta die. Everybody's gotta live.
before you know the reason why. Sometimes that going gets so good, then again it gets pretty rough. But when I have you in my arms, baby, you know I just can't get enough. Oh, yeah. Everybody's gotta live. Everybody's gonna die. Everybody's gotta live. You gotta live before you know the reason why. I saw a blind man standing on a corner yesterday, baby. He couldn't hardly tie his shoes, but he had a harmonica and a guitar strapped around his neck, and he sure could play the blues. Oh, yeah! Everybody's gotta live. Everybody's gonna die. I had a dream the other night, baby.
Obviously, I'm a competitive person. I never like to lose, but losing to a great competitor in Ryan, like, I can't hang my head too much. But obviously, I'll be depressed for about a month and a half, 2 months. But I'll get over it at some point. I'd like to thank the documentary workers, especially head director Charlie Shanley for all the work he's going to put into this editing and finishing this for all the people to understand the world of Catan through a different eye and a different camera.
Thank you.
Yeah, so like I expected, Ryan came away with the victory. He played well. He does very, very good strategy, strong strategy. He's unique. Was able to take advantage of the longest road. I gave it a shot at the end to try to take that point away from him. I came up one road short on my turn to hopefully extend the game. But I thought it was one of the better games. I think everyone was in it to the end. But again, I think we have to figure out a way to stop the red train, which keeps on running over us. Well, I always look forward to getting my second victory in 17 attempts. I think I'm really about to turn the curve and become one of the best Catan players in the history.
Well, you know, this is a great experience, and it was a hard-fought game. That's all I got to say. Get them next time, you know? I'll keep working harder every day, and I'll just play one-on-one against myself in Catan and get better every single time. So, until next time, peace out.
Said I was gonna win. Knew I was gonna win. I won. I think the biggest thing that got for me was getting that early 2-1 port plus the longest road, and then pretty much just a lot of infighting with everyone else. Got lucky with the 5 rolls and glad I won. And it makes me the first person to get to the 5 win in Catan Club. Suck it.
In conclusion, I've changed as a person. After diving into such an intense craft and watching such masters in their natural habitat, it opened a new perspective. It's just a board game, sure. But everyone, despite their fighting, hate, and arguing, loves each other. People play board games for various reasons. They enjoy the challenge, the social dynamic of the competition, the testing of skill versus skill, and or luck versus luck. I believe that people play Catan for the sense of community, the bonding aspect. Settlers of Catan is such a perfect game with such a general appeal that it may simply be the best game ever created. Regardless of your age, Catan does a great job at getting people to interact. To win, you have to interact and trade. In a way, the whole setup of the game takes you through a great adventure, which is creative and thrilling. Trading gets creative, tension is huge, and it really gets players to play together. After today, I'll never play a board game the same way. It was truly an honor to watch. So to Peter, Quinn, Ryan, and the Boomer, this is Charlie J. Shanley
signing off.
Charlie Brown, you don't have to feel so down.